Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be updating you with my morning skincare routine. So I'm actually all showered. I have sunscreen all over my body and the only thing I haven't done is wash my face and done my routine. So let's get started. My morning routine doesn't take as long as my night routine, of course, because I wake up with no makeup on. I'm actually trying to reduce the amount of products that I use because I just start to kind of feel like there's really no need for it. So now that my hair is up in a ponytail, just to kind of really prevent my hair from getting wet, I'm going to use this adjustable hair tie to kind of block my hair right where the hairline is, like so. And if you guys can tell, I actually have lash extensions on. So currently my routine, especially at night, has actually changed somewhat, meaning no oil-based products are going anywhere near my eyes because oils and lash extensions don't mix. It's going to affect the glue that's attaching the falsies to your real lashes, and it's going to make the false extensions fall off a lot faster. So first things first, I'm going to cleanse my face with a cream cleanser. Going in with this Lom Gel Balm Cleanser. It's a hybrid gel to balm formula, and it smells really herbal, and I'm going to show you guys how it looks. I have now rinsed my face, and I'm going to use this Lom Gel Balm Cleanser. It says you can use 1 to 2 pumps. I like to use 1 in the morning, so I'm going to pump it right here. And it comes off looking like this. It looks like a balm. It doesn't even look like a gel at first. Then once I rub it together in my hands and then onto my face, it's gonna look something really just like a hybrid formula like it says. So I'm gonna rub it together, and at the moment it looks like so. It feels actually kind of strange, I have to admit. I have never really felt a cleanser that feels like this before, but it really is true to its words where it's like a gel balm formula, because it does kind of rub down like a balm at first, and then eventually it becomes like a gel, especially the more you add water to it. This is not something that you need to mask at all, but whenever I cleanse my face, I cleanse it for about 60 seconds. But there is something about the hairlines too. I try to avoid dragging down my face, even though sometimes I do forget and I do it, because it's not really natural, but I continue to kind of massage. And now I'm going to rinse this off with some lukewarm to cold water. I've rinsed my face and I'm going to pat my face dry with this paste towel, but very gently. I normally prefer microfiber towels, and I do have most of them in my closet. But today I'm using this simple cotton one, but it's due for a wash pretty soon. It's also really important that you regularly rotate your face wash, because even though maybe you leave it out to dry, it can still collect bacteria and mold, and you don't want that to deposit on your face after you've just cleansed it. So now that my skin is a tiny bit damp, I'm gonna start with my skincare routine. Another thing that I actually do is before I start my skincare routine, it's really helpful to do this before if you wear contacts. I will put my contacts in before I do absolutely anything. So I'm gonna do that right now. And I do this because I just noticed that anytime I put contacts on after skincare or maybe makeup, it's a lot harder and kind of irritates your eyes a little bit. That's my contacts. Up next, I'm going in with this Hollywoodlashes Luxury Lash Serum, which I use every single morning. I focus this on the lash line, both upper and lower. My lower needs it a lot, but especially right now with my extensions in, I really need to kind of care for them. I refill them, or when I remove them, my real lashes aren't too damaged. And I remember that the first time I was using this lash serum in conjunction with having my lashes done, my real lashes were still super healthy and strong. Albeit, like, my real lashes, some of it had fallen off, but the rest, like the remaining ones, were still pretty good. Up next, I'm going in with the toner. This is the Graymelin Galactomyces Ferment Filtrate Multy Toner. Now this one is gentle enough to use both day and night, and I've been incorporating a lot of fermented products into my skincare routine. I've been reading a lot about it and seeing so many things online that it's actually just so good for you. So that is the toner. I focus all around the eyes and all over the face. I try not to wipe too much, but I also never forget the neck. I normally do my skincare right after the shower before I'm dressed. So a lot of the skincare products actually all goes all the way down to my nipples, but we gotta keep this video PG-13. Up next, I'm going in with an eye serum, and this is the Ordinary Caffeine Solution Eye Serum. It reduces appearance of like dark circles or like eye contours and things like that. I use just 2 drops, 1 for each eye. I drop it onto my ring finger, then I rub it together on my other ring finger, and then I dab all around my eyes, just the orbital bone, because the way you blink, the eye muscles will eventually carry the product into your eyes, and you don't really want it near there anyways. It could irritate you. But I mainly focus it right here because I'm not really using anything too active or things that I react to. I do my eye products first. Up next, I'm going in with an essence, and this is actually a Ceramide essence that I put into a little spray bottle, and I just do about 4 sprays. I'll list the name of this down below for you guys, but I just rub it together and tap, pat, 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 pat. I take the rest down my neck as well. You don't need an essence, and you don't actually need any type of eye product either. It's just really nice to have, and since I'm somebody who likes to indulge and really kind of take care of my skin on an extra level, this is like where I invest my time and money. It's really therapeutic and I see results. Up next, I'm actually trying out a serum. This is an Ulla Henriksen Banana Bright Vitamin C Serum. I got like a sample from a Sephora buy I made, so I'm pretty much gonna squeeze out all of it. But basically, this is the product. But it comes in this kind of like turmeric color. But I'm just gonna kind of dab this all around my face. It's actually a lot of product that I've squeezed up. I love vitamin C. I think it's like the best antioxidant out there. It's just the problem is there's so many types of vitamin C in the market. You don't know which one is like good, you don't know if it's just a derivative, and you don't know if it's like stable or solid, like how soluble it is either. Wow, actually that really covered my whole face. So I'm gonna take the rest onto my neck. Gosh, it smells really good. Fragrance is like not a bad thing, but if you're sensitive, I don't know if you're gonna like this. This feels amazing. I might take the rest of it just kind of down my... Some of you may think, oh my gosh, you just wasted like another day's worth of vitamin C. But I just really don't think that when it comes to the packages like that, you can kind of like contain it like over a day, just because I have another like more product left. It's not kept in its normal packaging, so I really like that smell. So this is the Waso Shiseido Fresh Jelly Lotion. I tend to use a lighter type of moisturizer now during the day, especially if I'm gonna go in with makeup later, because it's our summer right now and it's so hot in Thailand. Our summer is not a joke. It's really light. It's almost like an ampoule, I have to say. If you guys watch my videos, you know that I really love this line by Shiseido. Super gentle, super sensitive. And if I had a kid, I'd probably get them started on this line. If I want to splurge on them, of course. I recommend this for people with normal to oily skin. If you are dry skin, but you just want something lighter, this is also good. I think anyone can use this, especially sensitive skin people. Next, I'm going with the last step, which is SPF. Now, this is a PCA Skin Sheer Tint Broad Spectrum with an SPF 45. It says it's water resistant for 80 minutes. Now, this thing is super magical, but the smell. I don't know if it's because it's expired, because I've had this for a very long time and I should not be using it, but it's really hard for me to throw things away. But it comes out like a balm, and it looks like it's tinted, as it says. And it's actually very light, but do you guys see that? It just blends in. And as a dry skin person, I love this balmy texture. Like, it could easily be almost oily, but it's not. So if you guys don't like oil, don't worry. But it's just like, I feel like balms are a great alternative for like anyone who likes oily types of products, because I love anything that's oil-based. There's no cast too. It's slightly tinted, so I don't know how it's gonna be for people with even darker skin than me, but look at that. I love to wear this. This is maybe my third time using it. So up next, I'm going to use SPF on my lips. I'm still struggling to finish this Merrez’ca product. It's already at the end of its life, but I just kind of rub a lot of it and kind of add a little bit extra on my nose because I don't want it to go to waste. And just the top of my eyes here. I can't have it go too near my eyes because of the lashes, but definitely underneath. Because it's very hydrating. Dry skin like mine, I think underneath the eyes, I'll always use a little bit of hydration. But then I'm gonna go in with my La Prairie Ultra Protection Stick, and this is mainly focused for my lips. I'm gonna go off camera and then take this off and then add some sunscreen behind my ears as well, and I'll be right. Before I got dressed, I used this one for my body, which you guys have already seen. So now I'm going with one more step of SPF. This is for the body though. So I know I already put on SPF all over my body, but I'm adding an extra layer of this Glitter UV Essence by Parasola, and it feels super nice and hydrating. Comes out looking like this. I believe this is a chemical sunscreen. It has glitter. I love glitter. So this is focused on the areas where my skin is exposed because the rest of my body actually has a bit of a base sunscreen already. Behind my ears, of course. But that's pretty much it, you guys. That is my current morning skincare routine. This is what I do after I shower and before I get out to start my makeup and go out of the house to do whatever it is that I need to do. Hope you guys learned something today if you were curious about what I use. But that is it, and now I'm gonna go put on some makeup and go about my day. I'll see you guys in my next video.